Okay, listen, we need to talk seriously before anything gets out of hand. So, if you've clicked on the title and on the video, you would have known already by the title itself, talking about a Bleach console game, something that you guys have just been nagging and nagging and nagging and just keep. I mean, we want a console game, and we're going to talk about that in today's video and see what's going on with that. So, if you want to hear more up-to-date news about this game or about anything Bleach related, hit that like and subscribe. And of course, we're about to jump into it. So, let's discuss, shall we? Now, as many of you know, I'm not the greatest expert in terms of Bleach leaks in regards to the game companies. And, you know, I only know things about Soul Resonance. Of course, with things being said in the past, I have known that there was going to be a Bleach console game in the works. We know that it's, you know, Bandai own the rights now in comparison to what Sony or Sega did back in the day. And of course, I know things about Soul Resonance, which I'm not going to jump too much into this in today's video because that's a whole can of worms that, to be honest, I'm respecting the privacy currently of what's going on behind the scenes. But eventually, I will talk about it when due time. But first and foremost, we are going to be talking about the Bleach console game news that everybody wants to kind of know what the fuck's going on about in this regards to this news, which is a trademark licensing or filing that has happened within Europe, which Europe does have to disclose trademarks. Now, first and foremost, is this, of course, legit? Of course, yes, it is. It follows much of the same trademarks as the recent Dragon Ball Sparkling Meteor game that has been recently announced. Now, before anyone gets too excited about a console game, there is some kind of asterisks on, you know, a console game or a game in general, and I just do want to put out some pre-warnings in regards to that. But before I do that, I do want to say a Bleach console game is something that I've been talking about for a very long time, something that has been in the works or something that has been very much talked about and has been solidified for the longest of times. This not only by myself, but also, of course, by previous videos that I've stated, but of course, obviously by Kubo as well, also saying that someone within the team has also talked about a console game. So this has been very much, if not confirmed, it has especially been talked about within the production committee and also within Kubo's own area of team as of itself, or in Shueisha in short terms, which means the talks about a game have in fact happened on a console level, which is something everybody wants to happen. It's been in demand for a very long time, for the past 10 years, and for some reason, we just never had it because Sega just didn't want to do anything with it, or Sony didn't want to do anything with it, or now Bandai don't want to do anything about it. And we know that Bandai actually has the rights to Bleach because Piroshi, which is the president of CyberConnect 2, has outwardly said, not only on Twitter, but also in his Q&As, that Bandai now own the license, and if you want a Bleach game, to go and harass them. Of course, that word didn't really reach out on a bigger scale, unfortunately, whether the small margin of people that did find out about it did actually go and say something, or Piroshi's words itself actually reached Bandai as a publisher, because they're not developers, but as a publisher, that really goes to go and tell the tale. Now, hopefully it did, and to be honest, I do want CyberConnect to do it because I do trust them more than any other anime company, but I am more than happy to be surprised. However, if it is Bandai, chances are that I will know anything other than what I've already said publicly is little to slim, because I have criticized them. And you know how Western companies get about criticizing their games. They don't really like it. So I don't think I'm on their good boy points per se. But hopefully, Bandai, if you see this, let's talk. I'm a fan of Bleach. Hopefully your guys are a fan of Bleach, and let's do something together, but regardless of what. So now that we've got the fundamentals out of the way, that a Bleach game is happening and a console game is happening, the question is it this game in particular that is going to be that console game? And the game itself has been trademarked as Bleach Rebirth of Souls. Can we get a game of Bleach that hasn't got souls in it? Who knows? But it's a good meme, it's a good meme. It's an absolute good meme. Do I like the name? I don't really care. As long as the concept art looks good, as long as the logo looks good, I really like Soul Resonance kind of slapped, but Rebirth of Souls could go. Does it slip off the tongue? Not really, but hey, I'm open to the idea. So the game is called Bleach Rebirth of Souls, and it is a trademark within the European standards of trademarks. So this is very good, and we also know that this is from Shueisha itself. Do we know it's a mobile game or not? That's the big asterisk. Now, I do believe that this is going to be a console game. By all marketing strategies in my head, everything points towards a console game, but I wouldn't be a very good reporter if I didn't actually have to signify that, hey, there is a very, and I mean, to be honest, in my head, a very small margin that this is going to be a mobile game. But it's so minuscule, I don't think it's going to be the case, because nothing screams to me that this is a mobile game, if I'm honest with you. Based on everything that I know, from Soul Resonance to Bleach Brave Souls, this doesn't seem to me to be a mobile game. And chances are, if it was going to be a mobile game at this state, it's going to be one of those like bootleg Chinese games. And let's be honest, they're not going to do a trademark for Europe, especially have Shueisha also co-sign it. So this very much seems to me a console game that everybody has been asking for, and one that I've been anticipating the most. The developer, the publisher, obviously, we're not going to know. It is a trademark. These things are not going to be known for a very, very long time. Well, I won't say very long time, but I will say, especially with website domains, seem to be more sooner than trademark domains. But hey, anything can really go. It could be next week, it could be in a month's time, it could be in a year's time. We don't really know. A trademark's a trademark. To give you some insight on Bleach Soul Resonance, the trademark was kind of within, like, I think, the start of 2022, and there was kind of talks about domains being bought in 2021. So if that gives you an idea of when things start moving, there you go. You're looking at maybe late 2024, early 2025. Give or take, you'll hear some more news in regards to that. And I know what the comment section is going to be like. Oh, I want an arena fighter. Oh, I want a 2.5D fighter. Can we just appreciate the fact that we're getting a Bleach game? Granted, whether it's going to be a good Bleach game is nor here nor there. Though, I will say, as much as all the game fanatics and fighting fanatics or adventure or whatever type game it is, I will say, and I've always held this stance, is that I do believe it should be an arena type fighting game, because both competitive people and casual normies can play an arena fighter and enjoy themselves, and it can be competitive. And it is probably the most consumer-friendly product, I would personally say, unless you want to go for like a single-player thing like Kakarot did with Dragon Ball. That could happen too. Or maybe even something like Budokai Tenkaichi 4, maybe. But then again, I'm fine with that as well. I class that as an arena fighter. Is it an arena fighter? I don't know. I have not actually asked that question. I would say so. But yes, this is a whole video on basically me just waffling on what my thoughts on this is. It is going to happen. It has always happened with anime titles, very popular anime titles, which either get very popular or ones that have already pre-established themselves as an IP, is that usually with a production committee, another way that they make money is through games. And, you know, yes, we have BBS, and yes, that brings in a great amount of revenue, and it has proved itself to tell the tale. We have Soul Resonance, a new mobile game that's going to be happening, and of course a console game, which of course is going to bring in some good revenue for them too. And I do think it will succeed. You know, regardless of whether it's bad or good, I do think it will initially have like that J-Stars or maybe even Jump Force. Yeah, Jump Force didn't tell the tale, but to be fair, people bought it day one. And I do think that regardless of what people will think about Bleach, I think people will buy it because it is something that has been so much needed for the past 10 years that people will buy it just out of pure fandom alone. So I do think it will be a successful game. Now, will it live to tell the tale? That is another question. But I will say, if it anything by Naruto or Dragon Ball standards, is that even if it's a bad game, and if the franchise is possible, or popular, if it's popular enough, another Bleach game will keep repeating its cycle. Because if it is Bandai, and I will be honest, you know, from a professional and an opinion-based personal opinion, is that Bandai, you do shill Naruto way too much, to the point where you really want to rehash the original Naruto storyline yet again in a storm-like sense, just so you can milk the fans yet again. Try something new.